All right. Hello, everybody. My name is Tricia Katz. I lead our developer evangelism team at Magic Leap. So I work with creators across the globe, introducing spatial computing concepts and development on a variety of platforms, including Unreal Engine. If you have any questions after my presentation today on development, on enterprise, or just general spatial computing or Magic Leap, feel free to reach out to me. You can email me at tkatz@magicleap.com. You can also find me on Twitter at Tricia A. Katz. So I want to start by just introducing who Magic Leap is. Some of you may be familiar with Magic Leap, others may not. Magic Leap, we're building the future of computing. And so what that looks like is a personal spatial computing platform that utilizes our digital light field technology to seamlessly blend the digital and the physical worlds together. So we believe in moving beyond the screens and bringing what exists digitally out into the world around us as one. We believe that people should be first, that technology should serve us, that computing should match human experience, and also respect human physiology. We're building a world where entertainment and productivity and socialization become something to experience that's integrated within our real world. So I want to just level set a little bit. Many of you may have heard the terms VR or AR, and you may or may not have heard spatial computing. I want to talk about the differences and the term that we use, which is spatial computing. So with virtual reality, you've got a digital environment that shuts out the real world. You have a scene or scenes that were created just for you. Typically, it's a solo interaction, and you have no interface with the real world around you. Augmented reality might feel like a closer term, but it's not quite right. So with augmented reality, you've got digital content that sits on top of your real world, but the two don't really understand each other. They don't actually interact together. Whereas with spatial computing, digital content interacts with the real world and with you. So they blend together where your digital world can understand your physical world and the objects in it. We like to say that spatial computing is empathetic. I'll talk about the feature set here in a minute. What that means is that you've got access to a lot of device data. You've got access to what the eyes are doing, how the user's interacting, how they're moving about the 3D space. That data allows you to craft very unique and personalized experiences that are tailored to a specific user. We believe that spatial computing is the next human-computer interaction paradigm, and we believe in bringing more contextual and immersive interactive power to our users. So, this was a quote that was taken from Forbes where they talked about spatial computing and its impact on businesses and the world around us. And I really liked this quote for a few reasons. So they said, spatial computing is going to change our lives, not by taking something that already exists and putting it in our pocket, but by completely revolutionizing how we view and interact with the world. So the ultimate goal of spatial computing is to replace screens and flat displays with an entirely new paradigm for communication and collaboration. So truly reimagining the world and engagement and experiences that are centered around gestures and glances instead of screens. And we've seen enterprise companies that are super eager to adopt this new technology because it allows you to supercharge skill sets. So you've got AEC as an early adopter, architecture, engineering, construction, home improvement, manufacturing, obviously automotive industry, heavy machinery and consumer goods, and media entertainment. You also have a wide variety of use cases, and these are continuing to grow every single day as we see more individuals kind of come into this space, bringing their skill sets with them. So design modeling, being able to bring a 3D model out into the real world, viewing it, demonstration purposes, training and employee education, remote assistance and operations. So spatial computing offers an incredibly realistic but safe exposure to various scenarios and environments. Real-time information overlay, so you can use this alongside location-based experiences to deliver information that is unique and specific to a site. industrial sales, and more. If you haven't seen the hardware yet, this is a look at our Creator Edition, our Magic Leap 1. It consists of three components. You've got the light pack, the lightware, and the control. I have this with me today, so if you haven't seen it, please come find me afterwards. I'd love to give you a demo. So the lightware, it uses our digital light field technology with environment mapping, with precision tracking, and sound field audio. So you can really produce some great, rich experiences. The control, it offers touch and haptic feedback for a fluid sensory experience and spatial tracking with six DOF. So that means it allows for more natural interactions for the user that mimic their own hand movements. So up and down, left and right, rotational movements as well. And then the light pack is where the bulk of the processing power happens. So that's the engine. This is an untethered experience. And you can do a lot with spatial computing. So you've got access to the head pose, which is the position and orientation of the Magic Leap 1 in the real world. This is similar to camera position and orientation. It's an emerging input method. It allows you to gauge the user's intent, what they're focused on. You also have gestures and hand tracking. This is one of my favorites. So you've got access to 8 gestures currently. These are things like closed fist, open hand, closed point, relaxed point, pinch, thumbs up, and more. You also have access to hand tracking with key points. So in one of our latest OS and SDK updates, you got access to 15 key points per hand. So that's an entire skeletal representation of each hand. In our most recent update last week, with skeletal tracking, we also introduced the hand mesh API. So now you've got access to an entire hand mesh. With image tracking, you can detect and track 2D image targets in the environment as you or they move across the real world space. And with eye tracking, you've got access to the 3D point in space where a user is looking. You can also detect the centers of the eyes in the 3D space, as well as blinks. Audio, so audio input and output through our built-in speakers. You can use input as an input method. Capturing input and then using something to translate or drive experiences based on that. Multimedia, the playback of audio and video files or streams. And then world reconstruction. So building a representation of the real world environment using the on-device sensors. And you can use that for physics-based interactions, for placing virtual objects, or character navigation path planning. And I want to highlight the input methods just a little bit more from that list. So you've got head pose, eye gaze, gesture, and voice. These are incredibly important in an enterprise context where you want a hands-free interaction. So used together, we can interact with the world to create a natural human-computer interface. And developer tools. So I won't deep dive here, but I want to introduce you, if you're a creator, where you can kind of go next and what you can do. So we've got three components with Unreal Development. You've got the Lumen SDK. This is going to give you access to our APIs and features. You can download that via our package manager, the Magic Leap Package Manager. You've got the Magic Leap UE4 editor build. That is on the Epic Games Store. You also have access to Unreal Soundfield Audio, API documentation, and examples in our package manager. You can get this at creator.magicleap.com. This is a quick look at that. It'll allow you to access our creator portal. So if you're interested in getting started building spatial computing experiences with Unreal Engine, check out creator.magicleap.com. You've got access to our APIs, our docs, our guides, and our tutorials. You also have access to our build tools and publishing tools as well. This is one of my favorite development tools, and I always like to talk about it because it's very unique to Magic Leap. We call it Magic Leap Remote. It offers you 2 affordances, so it offers you 0 iteration. What that means is that you can do continuous development and continuous iteration without having to rebuild every time you make a change. So personally, for me, I love to use this with visual effects. If I'm making a tweak trying to get something just right, I use 0 iteration. It allows me to develop much faster and fine-tune my visual effects. You also have access to simulators. So if you don't have a device and you want to get started developing, or let's just say you don't want to build and run on a device every time, you can do that with our simulator, which also allows you access to virtual rooms to test your projects in. I want to talk a little bit about, we've talked about Magic Leap. I want to talk about the power of Unreal Engine and Magic Leap. So first and foremost, blueprints. Blueprints offer flexibility and fast iteration. They also open up development to non-engineers, which is critical in spatial computing, because as we continue to bring more people into this space, we're seeing individuals come with a variety of skill sets that are not necessarily development skill sets. Our Magic Leap API is fully enabled in Blueprints as well as C++, so you have options. You've got Blueprint nativization, so that allows you to convert Blueprints to C++ and really allow you to have massive gains in performance. You have access to an extensive tool set, so there are built-in tools for performance analysis where you can really see where performance is spent, and then you can focus on optimization in your project. And then visual capabilities. So we just launched Undersea. You can see it here at SIGGRAPH. And Undersea was built in Unreal Engine. In fact, we actually have one of our studios people right back there. We worked on the experience. And with Undersea, it was the highest graphic fidelity in spatial computing that we have achieved to date. It's a beautiful experience. And we could have only done that with Unreal Engine. We've also partnered with Epic to offer 500 Magic Leaps in their Epic Mega Grants program. So if you're a developer building Unreal Engine spatial computing experiences, you can apply. There's no deadline, and projects are accepted on a rolling basis. Now, Unreal Engine experiences are more than visually compelling. They've really offered us unique learnings into UE4 development workflows, as well as just conceptually how we think about future experiences and what we can do with this technology. Unreal has really allowed us to push the boundaries of spatial computing, and you're going to see that very clearly in two of the experiences I'm going to highlight today. So the first one is Undersea. Undersea is a room-scale spatial computing experience for Magic Leap 1. It was created with Unreal Engine, and it allows you to observe underwater life in a dynamically generated coral reef biome. It provides an opportunity for a sense of presence and connection between the creatures and the environment. And this quote from our studio's team sums up so well what we're excited about Unreal Engine and all that it offers for spatial computing. So they said, one of our goals was to create a visually compelling and immersive experience that pushes the graphical boundaries of spatial computing using Unreal and Vulkan 3.1 mobile on Magic Leap 1. It gave us a glimpse into the possibilities of building an experience that truly pushed the limits of our technology and our graphics hardware. The Undersea team really leaned into the strengths of the engine. So they were working with a small dev team of two, but a really strong technical art team. And the blueprint system served as a connector between the two worlds. Everything visual was also done with blueprints, from the UI to the onboarding system, as well as the visual effects. And they were able to continue optimizing and fine-tuning the experience until it was at peak performance, utilizing UE4's profiling system and blueprint nativization. Most importantly, with timelines for project launch, with the visual effects, and with the team dynamic and makeup, they would not have been able to do this project in any other engine. Now, I'm sure most of you have heard of Micah before. If you have not seen Micah, we're also demoing Micah here at SIGGRAPH. And Micah is our first digital human at Magic Leap. It's important that you note digital human, not digital assistant. Because in the context of enterprise, as we think about the future of work, and bringing in a digital human to co-create with us and collaborate versus working for us. Micah is a great example of how we relate to digital humans. We're learning a lot in that space, and we'll continue to share those learnings, as well as the impacts on how we treat and we interact with digital humans. Micah demonstrates that collaboration, working with you, not for you. She's incredibly lifelike. She's also just an example of a fully realized AI and the possibilities for digital humans as we move into the future. So throughout 2019 and for years ahead, we'll continue to develop and release new creator tools and pathways to enable spatial computing as well as our vision, which is the Magicverse. So while I can't predict the future, I can tell you the direction that we're headed. And this is based on the ideas and our technology goals that will take us there. So the first one, we've got four North Stars that drive our product development. We've got sensory field computing. This is devices that touch the senses, so that's sight and sound, but conceivably, it could be any of the senses. You've got live streams. So these are the sensors on the device. They see you as you move about spaces in the 3D world. You've got human-centered AI. So we don't believe in a generic AI. We believe in an AI that's very unique and personalized to an individual. And then layers. These are digital overlays on the real world within a city-scale space or world-scale space. They might offer different experiences atop a real-world location. The collection of these layers are what we call the Magicverse. So this is a look at the Magicverse and our spatial application layers. The Magicverse is an emergent system of systems, bridging the physical and the digital in a large scale and persistent manner. So it scales from room level to building to city to country and world scale. We see data, information, and experiences being unlocked within these environments from screens and servers and persisting at scale in contextually relevant physical environments. The Magicverse can provide massive economic amplifiers to communities around the world because it will enable communication and work to occur in completely new ways at fractions of the cost of current physical systems. So we just released our latest Lumen SDK and Lumen OS update last week. It was a great update. With each update comes further development of the Magicverse, as well as international deployment and enterprise enablers. So in our latest update last week, we now support internationalization and localization for the UK, Germany, and France. This is us just getting started with additional communities. We'll continue to expand that with our localization framework. The updates also marked another stage of cross-platform compatibility and mapping. So those are two key platform enablers in our vision of the Magicverse. We now allow support for multiplayer, multi-user scenarios through our out-of-the-box persistent coordinate frames API. And lastly, we achieved full skeleton tracking of the hand, so you now have access to that entire hand mesh through the API. So as we wrap up, I just want to say, I hope we continue to just connect and create together. That's what we're here for at Magic Leap. We want to help enable you to build spatial computing experiences and move into this next phase of computing. If you're on social media, you might be following Magic Leap. You should also follow Magic Leap Devs. That's where we talk about our latest tutorials for Unreal Engine, our latest updates with our SDK, and we also share experiences that other creators are building. You're here at SIGGRAPH, so we always say showing is better than telling. I can sit up here and talk all day about experiences, but seeing the experiences for yourself is really the best way to understand this technology. So we have Micah showing in the Immersive Pavilion Village, and Undersea is in the Immersive Pavilion Museum, South K. Go check them out. And last but not least, I want to leave you with a quote from our CEO. I modified it just a little bit. He said, spatial computing is here now. Write some code or use blueprints. Create, build, don't be passive, participate. Thank you.